Bottom of your screen, oil is actually, it's still down, but it's above $39 a barrel at the moment. This market sell-off, will it lead to a recession? Is it telling us that a recession is on the horizon? To Gary B. Smith, with this, why this economy, is it worse than the last recession? Gary B.?
Well, I think it is, Dagan. I think the market is telling a story. I don't think it would have panicked as much as it did this morning if the underpinnings were strong. But I think, and you know, we've discussed this over the past few weeks, maybe we differ a little bit. I think the basic underpinnings of the economy are pretty fragile right now.
Why, Gary? I look at gasoline prices falling. That's juice for the American consumer. I see a housing market that is stable and should get stronger because of low interest rates, a job market that isn't on its back. But are we so inextricably linked to the rest of the world that that's irrelevant?
No, I don't think so. And you make some great points, as usual, but let me counter them.
Okay.
Let's go with housing.
Give me your best.
All right. Well, I don't know if my best is even going to match you, Dagan, but I'll try. Look, housing, a lot of people are still underwater. The prices have not yet come back to where they were in, I think, 2005, 2006, where you had a lot of people buying homes. I'm not saying as many people are underwater, but they don't have any equity in their homes. Number two, you mentioned mortgage rates. Mortgage rates are actually going to start going up. I know that, because I'm moving, as you know, down to Florida, and I see mortgage rates going up every single day. Let's look at labor force participation. That's still at a 40-year low. And the flip part of that is people want to know, do I have a job? And if I have a job, am I making a decent wage? You well know wages have been stagnant for what, like 50 years right now? So people don't have any more buying power than they did back in the 70s. That's why no one feels rich anymore. That's a problem.
And one thing that's also a problem is people keep talking about the Federal Reserve, but you have a Federal Reserve that has not much firepower left. You do bond buying, it has less of an impact. People are talking about negative interest rates.
Yeah, exactly. You remember the days where if you were short the market, like at the open, you feared Greenspan or someone of those come out and say they're going to do some emergency stimulus, and the market was up like, you know, 1,000 points. Now, what are they going to do? They're going to come out and say, okay, maybe we won't raise rates in September. I mean, that's not good. Maybe that does bring the market up these days, but you're right. I think the Fed is out of ammo, and maybe they should have been out of ammo a long time ago. But I think that the problems are a lot more structural than that.
Gary B., good to see you, whether we disagree
or not.
Always. Gary B. Smith.